Hey everybody, it's Jang here from LegoJang.com with a Lego City set from the spring to summer 2013 releases. This is a brand new Coast Guard set, set number 60013. It's the Coast Guard helicopter set. 230 pieces. This was a $40 set. Let's check out what comes with it. Ta-da! All built already. Haha. Ready to go. Okay, so let's get right into the review then, and we'll start with the minifigures as usual. First off, this guy here is he's actually the one who's going to get rescued by this Coast Guard helicopter. He was out there sailing around his small catamaran, which we'll see in a minute, and it got into trouble. I guess his mast broke or something like that. And you see he was wearing his personal flotation device, which is very important when you're out on the water. No matter how good you are at swimming, those things can save your life. And you can also see what he looks like with the print underneath. Looks like he had a wetsuit on. That's cool. All right, let's move right along. And this here is a pilot for the helicopter. It's a Coast Guard helicopter pilot, and he's just going to be sitting in the cockpit, in the cabin of the helicopter, so you can see what he's got on. And then moving on, also a similar looking person with the way that he's set up with his same torso and the same legs, and also a helmet. This one actually has some scuba gear on, as well as a snorkel set, which is a little bit odd to have a air tank as well as a snorkel set. But anyway, he's a diver. He's going to be going down into the water to actually affect the rescue itself. And then we have one more crew member on the helicopter, and this is a female character. Good to see another female character. And she's got the new style of cap with the add-on headphones or headgear. Those could either be sound deadening, or they could also have sound hooked up to them so you can hear through them. You can see what the print on the torso looks like, but she has a radio separate, so maybe those are just ear muffs to help protect her from the sound of the helicopter and its engines and its rotor, which is all very, very close to her because she's going to be standing in the doorway right there. And then there is an animal. A shark is included with this set, just to let you know that these are very dangerous waters down there, so they give you a shark with set. I appreciate that. It's got the opening and closing jaw, has a little bit of snapping action to it. And because it's white, does that make it a great white shark? I don't think so. This size, I think a great white shark needs to be bigger than this. I think this is a good white shark, not a great white shark. You know what I mean? All right, let's move on. Get all these little things out of the way. One more little thing before we get to the main part of the entire set, the Coast Guard helicopter, of this Coast Guard helicopter set. This is the little catamaran sailboat that our poor victim who's on the water was sailing around. He was doing pretty good, and this is really nice looking. I like this. It has a surprisingly large number of parts on it. I like what they did here with making the tops of the sponsons extra wide. Actually use this, it's a helicopter rotor blade on there, and that helps to give it extra strength, because you can see right here there's not much strength right there. It's just holding on with one. That'll fall off easily until you bring this down. Really just makes it stronger, looks better. It's got a rudder right here which you can turn. See how that was put together, a little flag piece with just a couple of these pieces with the 90 degree angle that comes off the edge. Pretty cool. Sail, plastic piece, clear with a print on it. Copyright 2011, not a new piece, but I think it's the first time it's been used on a multi-hull boat. And I really like how the mast is attached. That really impressed me, because see what they're using there? Just a couple of those C hook pieces, and this can come down. So that's simulating the mast actually being broken off and damaged. And you can also rotate the entire sail around to simulate different points of sail. You can just turn this like so, you know, so he's going downwind, he's at a close point of sailing close to the wind, you know, tack. Can't really tack with this, unfortunately, because it's kind of stuck on just one side, but it still looks really good. And I like this. Let me go ahead and put the sailor on it so you can see what he would look like standing up, and he would be probably controlling that boom up close, and his head would be turned looking in the direction where he's going, like so. Or maybe if he's got so much wind going on, perhaps he would actually be sitting down and leaning back. Let me see if I can get him to sit in that spot. Leaning back like that, you know, so it's kind of, you know, sailboats, especially catamarans, they'll get up on one hull like that and just sail along like that. So that's pretty cool. You know, we got different options for how you can use it. And it's actually possible, I think, to have two minifigures sitting on this one boat. That looks really good. I'm happy with that. All right, let's move on to the helicopter itself. I have to zoom out because this is a pretty big one with a large rotor set. Okay, first off, most important thing to point out here is that we do get a new piece for 2013, a new canopy for aircraft use. And that is really good looking, especially for helicopters. I think we're gonna see it used on airplanes also, but I think it makes the most sense on helicopters, or I guess rescue style airplanes maybe, or maybe like surveillance style airplanes, but really seems the best used on a helicopter like this. You can also see that there's a piece underneath to match the shorter nose here with a nice, almost perfectly circular round section in the front here. Looks really good. That is a sticker there on top. That is a sticker there, matching one on the other side. See, they use a little transparent piece in here to give the marker lights. That was done very nicely. So that's pretty cool. And then we've got older pieces used back here for the tail section of the fuselage, bottom and top. Familiar building techniques there. Nothing too fancy. Nice, again, just nice size on this. I especially appreciate the blades, the six bladed setup. There's a lot of weight to it, so this is gonna want to continue spinning on its own quite a bit. Looks really good. A little bit of offset there, so it's not perfectly centered. That looks really, really good to me. Good amount of detail and shape up in the engine area. We've got twin turbine engines on the sides. That's all good. The tail section, the middle, the tail boom, I guess, is kind of plain looking. I'm surprised they didn't actually put any tiles across the top of that to smooth it out, but it's okay. Looks fine, and looks really good from this angle. I'm glad that they had a longer horizontal little stabilizer section right there. Underneath, you've got fixed landing gear, pieces we've had quite a number of times. Single wheels here, double wheels here, with a little indicator light for taxiing, I guess a taxi light. And then there's a winch also, and this is one of those winches, you can see the button right here, that actually will retract itself. So that would be able to grab something. However, in order to grab something, you've got to be able to attach something to it. And this is not one of those types of pieces that a minifigure can just really grab onto well. That doesn't really work right there. It's not really designed for that. But here's how you use that. I'm gonna zoom in so you can see this more carefully, because it's a larger hook. But this guy is actually gonna be able to turn his hand and stick it in. Come on, rotor blades, get out of the way. There we go. He's gonna be able to turn his hand and stick it in this way from the side. So that's how he actually grabs on to the hook. It's not the most safe, the most good feeling kind of setup. Personally, I'm not a big fan of that. It's kind of rough. Let me see if I can get a better angle for it. If I turn them this way, this is what they show on the box art. They show it kind of like that. legs, so it kind of locks it in a little bit. So it does work, but it's kind of up in his face. It's a little bit awkward, but it does work. So that will allow you to lower him down, and you can definitely pick up some larger stuff with this also. Now, here's the thing that I don't like about these self-retracting winch setups, which I've already looked at a fire helicopter that had one of those in it. It's the fact that this really has a lot of pressure on it, and I've been told by a lot of YouTubers before, well, you have to push the button in and then it becomes easier. No, it does not become any easier. It is tough to pull this out for younger kids, especially not having a lot of patience. You're going to be pulling the minifigure off frequently. It's already tough enough to get him to stay there. So that I'm not really happy with that. The thing that I am happy with these self-retracting ones, the fact that they are self-retracting. If you haven't seen that before, here goes. There you go. Back up to the top. And this actually has a little bit of angle, so you can point it down so you can be in a little bit closer to the whole thing. And I'm just gonna wind this just a little bit more so it'll work better next time. You can see you can get him up pretty close right there. And once again, have to pull on the hook, not the guy. Pushing the button doesn't do any good. Ah, that's really hard. It's really unfortunate. It's gonna cause the string to fray quickly and easily if this gets used a lot. It'll probably break pretty easily. You need to have an excellent knot down here, otherwise you should pull on the string itself. I still recommend pulling on the string because knots are tough to get right. Maybe put a little bit of super glue in there just to get it even stronger. But once you push the button, up he comes, and there he goes, right to where he started. So that's pretty close. Depending upon where you angle this out. Up, there we go. Up, 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 there, up, up, up. There we go. Up, there we go. You can get him farther away or closer. This character here, the female character in this one, would normally be standing there, but there's not enough room for her to stand. That would be the more realistic thing for her to be standing there. They show her kind of angling out the edge on the box art, and that's not appropriate because it doesn't really work that way. Trying to get her to sit in place, she has to kind of be moved in. You really want her to be there because she's directing the descent, and she's directing the use of the winch. So it's kind of tough for her to even sit. They're just kind of sitting on the edge. That's about the best that I could get, which is it's kind of disappointing for something this large to not be able to fit a person in that spot. And plus, you're wanting to rescue a person here. So once your sailor, who this guy is going to be picking up, once your sailor has been brought back up to the top, then what? Now where's he going to go? You've got this person already there. Your diver needs to go somewhere. Of course, it's first priority to save the regular citizen, so maybe he can sit on the edge. Come on, get on the edge. There we go. So he's sitting on the edge, kind of looking forward, and then you've got the cockpit area, which opens up pretty easily. That's pretty nice. It's just pretty basic in there, but got a couple of control levers and a little control panel. Let me get my pilot figure, minifigure here. Set him in place. See, he's got a nice spot to sit. That's appropriate for him. Where's your diver gonna fit? Maybe you can just barely fit him in behind there. It's just a tight squeeze. He has to take his fins off probably to fit. Yeah, you will definitely have to take his fins off to fit in there. Have to take off his equipment. I don't know where his equipment is gonna go. His helmet, his breather tank, his air tank, rebreather tank probably. I don't know. It's really cramped in there. It's a really good looking helicopter. I like the build. I like the final look. I like the new parts. They have nice personality to them. For the front, that looks good to me. The rotor, I love the rotor. The gear work out well. I do like this little catamaran over here. That is a nice extra detail or extra piece, extra assembly to have in with this set. Adding in the shark. sharks or animals, Lego animals tend to be expensive, so I'm happy to have one of those added in. But on the whole, the playability is a little bit low here. I wish that they just had enough room to stand your minifigures up inside of that helicopter. It would have made so much more difference, or it just would have been better, period. But I still like the set. I still like the look of the thing. I like the colors. I like the level of detail. Price now? Okay, $40. Nowadays I just don't talk about price much unless there's something really spectacular about the value, either good or bad. And in this case, the price per part is something like, it's over 17 cents per part in the US, based on the $40 recommended selling price. And that's astronomical compared to the norm. The norm is in the 10 to 13 cents range. 13 is a little on the high side. You'll see some things that get down to 9 cents per part that are pretty good deals. So 17 cents per part, that's rough. Now, you have to temper that with the understanding that this is a very large single piece right there. Large piece there, large piece here, large piece here. So it has a number of large pieces on it. These are also fairly sizable. So the overall size of the things ends up being a little bit bigger than the parts count would suggest. But still, it's not that much bigger. And for $40, I would expect more. I would want more than this. I would want this to be a $30 set, $35 at the most. $35 is really pushing it, but $30 would make it a very, very good value. $40, I feel, is a little bit much. If you like this set, you really, really want it, you really want that helicopter, and you've seen how it works with the limited space on the inside here, you still like it, go for it. Like I said, I still like the look of this, and I'm still glad to have it personally. But for folks who are on a limited budget looking for maximum playability and value for your dollar, this probably isn't the one for you. So that's it. That takes care of my views on this set. Once again, set number 60013 from LEGO City, summer 2013 Coast Guard releases. It's the Coast Guard helicopter. Thanks for watching, and I hope to talk to you again very soon in another video.